Hi there, welcome to another Tomorrowland Inspiration session. This time I'm joined by Lucy Charles-Barclay. Hi Lucy.
Hey, thanks for having me. It's really cool to be here speaking to you.
Well, that's very kind of you to say. Obviously, Tomorrowland is going all around the world, and I'm not mistaken if I say you are in the UK at the moment?
Yeah, I'm in the UK at the moment. I live near London, so I'm pretty lucky where I live. I also live near Epping Forest, which I don't know if anyone's heard of, but it's an amazing forest for cycling and running in.
Okay, yeah, because that brings us, of course, to your profession. You're a professional triathlete, specializing in Ironman and 70.3 distances. Now, Lucy, there might be a few people watching who don't really know what a triathlon is. So for them, I'll just say it is the most physically demanding sport in the world. Can you subscribe to that?
Yeah, I'd say it's definitely up there with one of the most physically demanding sports, particularly the distances that I race. So the Ironman distance is crazy long distance where you swim, bike and run, and it normally takes me just under 9 hours to complete the distance. So it's a long day out there. It's pretty brutal.
Yeah, because it is 2.4 miles of swimming, 112 miles of cycling, and the marathon. That's the Ironman distance. That's crazy. So we're very interested to get to know your story, of course, because it all started with you being a professional swimmer. That is actually what you grew up to be.
Yeah. So when I was about 8 years old, I started swimming, and I was always like trying to find what was the most difficult event to do in swimming. And then like, oh, there's another one that's even harder. So I think I was about 9 years old and I wanted to swim the 200 meter butterfly event, which there's not many 9 year olds that want to swim that event. And then at 16, I found open water swimming and like the long distance. So I went and did the 10K marathon swim and just missed out on the London Olympics. And then pretty much after that, a couple of years later, I decided to give triathlon a go and signed up for my first Ironman in 2014. So yeah, I went from swimming to triathlon and yeah, I've enjoyed both sports, but I'm definitely having more fun doing triathlon.
Yeah, it's not a step that everyone makes from being a professional swimmer to triathlon. What made you take that decision? Was there a passion bubbling underneath, or?
Yeah, so my husband and I actually went and competed in an open water swimming event that was in Scotland, and I had a terrible race. I was just so disappointed with it that we actually went back to the hotel we were staying at, and just on kind of like a spontaneous crazy whim, we decided to just sign up for an Ironman, which was going to be the following year. So we trained for it together. My husband actually has a sports science degree, so he had quite a bit of knowledge around training, but it was still a learning curve for him, and a steeper learning curve possibly for me. But we did our first Ironman distance in July 2014 in Bolton. And yeah, it was a really, really great experience. It was one of those days where all we wanted to do was make it to the finish line, and it didn't matter what time we did it in. So it seems like a whole different life ago already, because now when we race, it's all about getting to that finish line as fast as we can and trying to win these races. So I kind of loved it back then because it was so zero pressure, just need to finish, doesn't matter how long it takes. But yeah, it's been an amazing journey to this point.
Yeah, and like you said, I mean, 9 hours, and maybe perhaps you're aiming for 8 hours of doing the competition. I mean, it's a crazy performance that you have to put in every single time, and also, I mean, you have to get good at cycling and running. Did it take a lot of effort, or are you a natural talent?
I think my background in swimming definitely helped. Obviously, I started swimming when I was 8 years old, and around the age of 16, I decided to do more of the endurance, longer distance swimming. So I was building up this very good endurance engine, but Ironman is a completely different beast. So I definitely had a steep learning curve on the bike. I fell off so many times learning how to ride a bike, particularly when you're clipped into the pedals.
Yes.
I just would like stop at a traffic light and then fall off.
Oh, yeah. We've all been there.
So,
yeah.
So many people were laughing at me saying, you might be an amazing swimmer, but you really need to learn how to ride a bike. And I was like, I'm confident I will do it. It's just going to be a process of learning. Mm-hmm. And then the same really for the run. I was always quite a natural runner. I used to run at school. I do the cross country. I go to the athletics meets, but I never had done that kind of mileage. So my body just kept getting injured because it just wasn't used to that pounding of the pavement when you're running. Obviously, as a swimmer, there's just zero impact. So running was completely new to my body. And again, I just had to make sure that I paced it very gradually in building up mileage because my body just was not used to it.
Oh. Also, what springs into my mind is mentally, it's a very, very tough sport. How do you keep your motivation, not only during the competition, but just in the weeks and months of training?
Yeah, it's definitely super tough. I mean, I'm training probably on average around 30 hours a week, so it's a lot of training. And that obviously physically takes its toll, but mentally takes its toll as well. And you have to just keep yourself motivated and driven towards a goal. So like last year when racing just wasn't happening, it was so hard because I'm used to just having that goal that I'm working towards. And I think most people are like that in all walks of life. You have a deadline or a goal that you're working towards. And when that's taken away, it's really, really hard. So this year, I've kind of had a completely different approach to my racing and my triathlon, and pretty much any opportunity that's been thrown at me, I've just grabbed it with both hands and jumped in and kind of given it a go. So I've been doing some different kinds of racing this year, and that's definitely kept me motivated and pushed me out of my comfort zone a little bit as well. So I think having a goal to work towards is a massive part of keeping yourself motivated in your training. But then also, obviously, like you said, racing for 8-9 hours, your mind goes to all kinds of places. So I will always go to like dark places in a race where I'm like, can I actually carry on? Can I keep doing this? And it's usually during those moments that I remember the training that I've done and the hard sessions that I've got through week in, week out, where I've worked towards the one race that I'm doing in that moment. So yeah, it can actually be more of a mental battle on race day than physical. I think you've done all the physical work in training, but it comes down to what's going on in your head on race day to get yourself across that finish line.
Yeah, but the payoff in the end, I think when you get through these dark places, like you say, I think it must be very rewarding at the end, no?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing for me was I'd had some highs as a swimmer. When I finished races, I was always super happy and elated. But when I crossed that finish line of that first Ironman, I had never felt anything like it. It was like the biggest high I'd ever had. And I was like, almost got addicted to that feeling. I was like, I want to do that again. I want to feel that again. And I think it is just because it's such a long day to get to that finish line, and there's always points in that day that you're not sure if you're going to make it. So when you do cross that line, you're just absolutely buzzing, particularly if you've had an amazing race as well where things have gone right and maybe you've won the race. Then you just, there's no high like it that I felt. So I definitely love that feeling, and that's what motivates me to train, to go and get that feeling again.
Yeah, I'm a sports journalist here in Belgium, and I've interviewed quite a few Belgian triathletes, and they all say the same thing. It's the best thing in the world for them, but it's just such a such a big performance to even finish that race, let alone win it like you recently did in Denmark, of course. Do you consider yourself a role model?
I think I still feel so new to this sport, so it's kind of, sometimes I can't believe I've become a role model in the sport, but I definitely hope that I am someone that can inspire other people to maybe not do Ironman, but just push themselves out of their comfort zone, try something new, challenge themselves. And it really is a sport in triathlon where there's just so much respect across all athletes and all abilities, because just to finish an Ironman takes so much dedication and so much work. So whether you're doing it in 8, 9 hours or you're going and doing it in 17 hours, there's just respect there because it's such a tough day. So that's one of the amazing things about this sport is just it doesn't matter what ability you are, everyone has that respect and admires what you're doing, no matter how fast or how slow you're doing it.
No. You already mentioned your husband, who is also a triathlete champion, of course. Reese is his name. Does that help having a husband, somebody who completely understands the things you have to go through during a race and during training?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, I know a lot of long course triathletes who do it all on their own, and I just don't know how they do it. Like, that takes some mental ability to just day in, day out, do it on your own. So I feel so lucky that my husband is doing it with me. He's an athlete himself. He's also my coach. So
Oh, yeah.
he is there every single day, helping motivate me, observing what I'm doing, adjusting our training plan on the go to make sure that it's suiting how I'm feeling. If I'm feeling super tired, he may change the plan so it's a little easier. If I'm feeling really good, he may make it a bit harder. So it's a really cool dynamic that we have, but we definitely bounce off each other in training. We rarely argue at training, but we will argue about normal kind of couple stuff. So, but we're very good at distinguishing between kind of the conversation that we're having. So we can have a debate about what sessions I'm doing or what the triathlon plan looks like. And then that wouldn't cross over into our normal life. So, it's a lot of people question how it could work, but it definitely works for us.
It's like you're wearing different hats, like you're wearing the coach hat and then the other next moment he's wearing a husband hat. So it's all about picking those moments. What is the hardest part about being a triathlete?
I think the hardest part about being any athlete at the elite level is just how much you have to sacrifice. So I spent my whole life being an athlete, so you constantly are sacrificing things. Maybe you can't go out and do the fun things that your friends are doing because you've got training to do, and there's obviously hours and hours of training to do. But then on the flip side of that, the reward is so great if you've put that dedication into your work. So I've kind of been sacrificing my life since I was 8 years old to be an athlete, but I kind of feel like 20 years on now, it's definitely been worth it. I'm kind of at the top of my game in triathlon and getting those performances that I've been working towards since I was a little kid. So I think it's always worth it making those sacrifices.
Is this because you started as a professional swimmer and now you're a triathlete? Do you think there is a new sport on the horizon, perhaps in 10 to 15 years, or is this just your thing now and probably also the last sport that you will do professionally?
Yeah, I think it will probably be the last sport I do professionally. I think when I'm done with triathlon, I would explore all kind of sports. There's just, I can't sit still. So I would definitely go and experiment with different things. But the different thing I've done this year is actually explore the shorter distance triathlon, which is the distance that will actually be in the Olympic Games. So I did my first race of that distance this year, and had a really good performance with minimal preparation for the race. My training for long distance triathlon is obviously very different. So one of the things that I will be considering is trying to qualify for the next Olympics, which is in Paris in 2024. And then if I manage to do that, I would definitely go back to the long course triathlon after that, or try and balance the two. But it's never really been done well in triathlon. So I would definitely be putting myself to the test if I could do both at the same time. But it's a goal that definitely excites me within the triathlon. But the great thing also about long distance triathlon is you can do well at this sport quite late into your life. So there's athletes that are, well, in the men's side, there's athletes that are in their 40s that are still absolutely crushing the racing. So you can definitely have a long career in this sport. So I feel like I've still got a long time left doing triathlon before I go and explore some other different sports. I've always wanted to go and do surfing, skiing, all these kind of more extreme sports, but whilst I'm doing triathlon at this elite level, I feel like I have to wrap myself in bubble wrap so that I don't need so we'll save that for later in my life so I can go and try some different sports.
Yeah, still many goals for you to reach. That's how your life is. It's like, it's all about getting to the next goal, achieving another goal. Thank you very much, Lucy. Do you have any final words of wisdom for the people of tomorrow?
Oh, I think my biggest thing when I came into triathlon was I'd actually fell out of love with swimming. I just put so much pressure on myself. So when I came into triathlon, it was all about trying something new, challenging myself. But the main thing was just having fun with it. So I feel like I've had more success by far in triathlon just because I love what I'm doing. So that would be my message, is just whatever you're doing, make sure that you are loving it. You only get one life. So whatever you're doing, go out there, have fun. And I'm sure you'll be more successful if you have fun doing what you're doing.
Perfect. Thank you very much. I'm very true. Thank you, Lucy.
Thank you.